So I've logged into my Office 365 account. I have the account for small to mid businesses on my if I click on this waffle menu, I will see the button for the bookings app. So I just click the bookings app. And it will directly bring me to the landing page for Office 365 bookings. So the first thing that I would need to do is to in order to set up is to put my business name. And business type. So, as you can see, it's doing the setup, and I only need to do this once. So, once it's set up, it opens this page for me, and there's nothing else I need to do in terms of configuring the app. It's all there for me to use out of the box. So, once you're here, you can configure the page to add things like adding your logo. So, what are the essential items you need to set up on your bookings page so you can publish and have people booking directly online to set up appointments with you? One of the important things is to put in your business information, which will include your address, the location, if this is a physical business, if this is something that your customers need to go and see you to get the service, the business hours, and like we mentioned before, the logo. And then the next thing is to have your services, which is really important. So if you are a hairstylist, you might want to list here the different types of services you offer, whether it's haircut, coloring, shampoo, blow dry, those types of stuff. You'll put it here. So to add a service, you just click Add Service, and then you'll put in the type, the name of the service of how you would call it. So for this instance, we'll say and then a description of your service and the duration. And normally these appointments have more or less the same duration of time, and then your pricing. So there are different types, from free to fix to a starting point on an or an hourly. So if it's fixed, you just put in the price. Type of how much you it would cost if it's hourly, what's your charge per hour for the service? And then it gives you the option to modify fields. So if there's something that you would need from your customers when they book the appointment, so the default is the customer email is a required field. So you might want to have the phone number so you can call and follow up. And if there are special requests that the customers want. And you can also add fields that are pertinent to your business. So once you're done with that, you go and save. And then you can add as many services as you would want. And then the next thing is equally important is to have the list of your team members that are going to be either managing the bookings or performing the services that are being booked through your website. So this is where you would add. So for this one, we have the default test account that we have for this account we're using for demo purposes. The calendar tab gives you a view of any appointments that have been set. And as you could see up here, it's color coded depending on who has an appointment scheduled. You can somewhat customize your bookings page. It's not massive customization, but it's very simple and it will get you going right away. You can select the color that somewhat matches your brand. And then if you have any booking policy or scheduling policy. If you just want increments to always be 1 hour, if you want that your appointments are set 24 hours in advance, it means that, someone has to give you at least a day's notice, and someone can give up to a year's booking in advance. And you can change this to just note that the minimum lead time is in hours and the maximum lead time is in days. So once you've already have that set up, you go save and publish, and then you will have this link which you can copy and put it on your website, or tweet it out or share it on Facebook. So what does this page look like? So as you can see, it's very simple and but very easy to use. So once you share this on your website or you share the link to your clients, all they have to do is select the date and, oh, because we said minimum one, see, we said minimum, select, and then select the service. As you can see, if your calendar that's linked to you, you have something scheduled on those dates already, then you wouldn't see those dates as being available on your calendar. So on our website, we have a link to our bookings page. So you can either share the link or embed the link of your point of your bookings page. In our case, it just worked better if we just had a link. So as you can see, we offer three types of consultation just because this is the type of bookings that works best for our type of business. And like I said, if we are not available for that time, you would not see any services. So, and then once they select a serve, oh, so first thing is they need to select a service. So I wasn't sure. So the type of service that they would want to book, and then on the calendar, select the date. So anything in the past has been grayed out. Days that are not available are also grayed out, like weekends. And then here, like Monday is pretty open. I can just select 8 a.m., put in my name and my email and the optional information. And then, and then click book. And then a message will appear that the booking has been confirmed. So since these are the times I know that I'm open, it's because it's synced to my calendar, or the people that are responsible in doing this thing, it's synced to our calendars. There's no need of the back and forth. My clients or prospects get to choose the date and time that work best for them, and then they book the appointment, and then a confirmation gets sent. It's put directly on my calendar, and since I put in their email address, I can follow up with an email if there are additional information I need. But everything is done right away without all this back and forth and, giving, checking if which date works for whom best and those type of things.